Guys, if you are running Google Ads, okay, it's very, very important that you have all of the conversion tracking set up correctly. Now, there are a number of different settings that may be overlooked. It's really important to align with the best practices so that your conversion tracking is on point, so you can best harmonize with your ad AI, so you can train your ad AI with the inputs and outputs needed to get the best results. What's going on, gang? It's your boy, Jerry the Ad Wizard, coming back at you with a brand new video. And today we're going to be looking at something super essential if you're running Google Ads and you want to know how it all works together with Google Ads, Google Tag Manager, and Google Analytics. Stick around, guys, because we're going to go and do a deep dive on conversion tracking so you know how to set things up correctly. So if you don't have some of these settings set up correctly, they could have a detrimental impact on your ads. You could be spending money on ads that aren't optimizing properly, meaning in the long term, you're missing out on potential profit and you're missing out on potential learnings for the ad AI, meaning that you're wasting money and you're burning time. Okay, so sit back, relax, grab your coffees and grab your hats. It's time to spin up some ad magic. So we're here on the Google Ads Manager, and this is where the first step that we're going to set up some conversion tracking. So you're going to go into Google Ads Manager and then you click here under goals to see that the pop-ups there are about conversions, summary, value rules, custom variables, settings, and uploads. We're just going to create a very simple conversion here today. So you're going to scroll down under this chart section, which we can set up later on. You press create conversion. And here you're going to have an option. What kind of conversions are you going to be tracking? Stuff going to your website? Are you going to be tracking app installs? Are you going to be tracking other phone calls related to your business? You can also import some conversions as well, which if you have this set up in Google Analytics, you can import some conversion events from there. I'm going to show you how to add your Google Analytics conversions into Google Analytics. Now, for purpose of this demonstration, it's going to be website sales and it'll be people filling out a form and marking that as the conversion. People are going to submit their lead details. They want to do some business with you. And then when they reach the thank you page of the sign up process, that is where the conversion event will fire. And that is where we tell Google, hey, something's happened here. This is the type of action that we want to optimize for, and we want to find other audiences that are going to resonate with that end optimization conversion comp. Now, what we're going to do is add our website domain and then press save and continue. It can scan the website and give you suggestions on conversion events, but if not, we're going to add in the conversion events manually exactly where we need to on that thank you page. And because it's saying this website domain is linked to a Google Analytics account, you can choose Google Analytics to measure your new conversions and also use them in the Google Ads to help run your campaigns. So we're going to scroll all the way down to the bottom and add a conversion action manually. We're going to press this and it's going to open up a new screen. Under the select category, there are so many different types of conversions that we can utilize for us and our business. We're talking about submitting lead details into a form on our website. So the most appropriate category for us right now in this particular demonstration is submit lead form. It could be that if you're selling something on your website, the category is purchase, add to basket, or begin checkout, with purchase probably being the main one. So for the demonstration purposes, I'm going to put submit lead form. But if you've got multiple different forms on your website or multiple actions, it's good to label these conversions with different names. For this demonstration, we're just doing that one conversion action, so I'm just going to label like this. But if you're targeting certain people, for example, you can mention that in the conversion name. It's very important to organize and categorize conversions so that you know exactly which one that you're looking for in the Google Ads, Google Analytics, and Google Tag Manager. So for conversion name, I'm going to put submit lead for. Here, we're going to skip past the value section. Don't use the value for this conversion action. I'm going to do this simply now because we haven't created a model that quantifies the value of leads. If you're selling something for a certain price here, you can tell Google how much the value of that conversion is. Then it can optimize and utilize the conversion value so that Google knows exactly how much that conversion is value to you. Now you're going to go to count, and under here, you're going to put, depending on how many conversions per click or interaction. So every purchase is valued, whereas if you select one, it's recommended for lead signups and other conversions because only the first interaction is valuable. So I'm going to select one because even if a lead submits their details multiple times, it doesn't count as multiple conversions being hit. Google will understand it's the same user doing the same conversion action, therefore only counts as one. This means that we don't get many duplicates. And then what you want to do is scroll down to the bottom. A lot of these conversion windows, we're going to leave the same under recommended, under enhanced conversions. Make sure that this is ticked, guys. Use enhanced conversions for this action. This means that the data is even more solid getting passed back to Google, that the ads can optimize a lot quicker and a lot better. If the enhanced conversions is on, it means that the ad AI can learn. And I'm going to show you exactly where to implement those settings in Google Tag Manager as well to make sure that everything is cohesive, that all the data is getting transferred, and the user provided data is also getting input correctly. And then you're going to press done down here. And then under settings, what you're going to do is press save and continue. So we have here the submit lead form conversion coming up. And how are we going to install it, guys? We're going to use the Google Tag Manager. So click here over the Google Tag Manager. And I'm going to show you where to input the ID for the conversion event. So this is the information that we need. Now we're going to open up Google Tag Manager. And what we're going to do is we're going to fill in this key information into Google Tag Manager and input it there. So first thing, going to go over to tags. Now what you want to do is call it exactly what it was called under the conversion. So submit lead form is the name of it. And that's what I'm going to call it, the Google Tag Manager. So just copying that in like that. Then you want to go on tag configuration, click on Google Ads here and click on Google Ads conversion tracking. Here we can input some fields and we're going to use the information from the Google Ads Manager. So first of all, I'm going to bring it over from Google Ads. The conversion ID is here and we're going to bring it into Google Ad Tag Manager. And then this is the conversion label. So in the field below, we're going to input the code section that is underneath the name of the conversion that we have just created, this code here. Okay guys, but before we go anywhere else and you're new here, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe. Make sure you hit that notification bell so you never miss any more important updates. We are here many times a week to help business owners, online advertisers, and digital marketeers get the best from their online advertising, paid media, and digital marketing strategies. But without further ado, let's get on with the video. Let's scroll down and you want to press here, include user provided data from your website. I've made a whole video around why user provided data is so important and how to implement it in Google Tag Manager. But we're going to select include user provided data from your website. So that's setting up the tag. Now we need to set up a trigger which fires when that tag is activated. So to do that, press on triggering. It's going to bring up a new window. Press the plus button at the top, which is going to create a new trigger. So here we're going to label the trigger and call it the same name that we got for the conversion and the tag name. We're going to add that in as the trigger name as well. So it's all seamless and organized. Now what you want to do is click on trigger configuration, scroll down to form submission. So here we're going to press some forms and then press form URL. And there's going to be two options, either form URL or page URL. And then it's going to say we need a certain page URL where the form is located. I'm on the lead form, and what we're going to do here is just type in the URL of the form. No need for a thank you page. Just type in the name of the form that we have on the website, and then we're going to press save. Now, there's another way that we can do this. If this doesn't work for you, try this alternative route. You press save, and then everything's saved together. Now, on the alternative, I'm going to show you a different way of doing this. I'm going to press triggering again to change the settings so that you can see the settings that we're going to be utilizing instead. What we're going to do, instead of form submission, we're going to do page view. And page URL contains them to the thank you page of the form. So when somebody enters their information in here, they get brought to a thank you page. And we're going to use that URL from the thank you page and add it in here. What I like to do is just remove the beginning of that URL. That then says that this conversion is firing when the page URL equals /thank you. There's two methods of doing that. Form submission and just using the URL for the form. Google will recognize when somebody has submitted that. Or straight into when the page view equals thank you after somebody submitted. So what we're going to do is press save. And here is we're going to go back into the Google Ads in the very left-hand corner here. I'm going to press done. Now, it's going to bring us back to the goals view. And then when you scroll down, you'll be able to see the conversion event that's been added under the category that you have just created. So for us, it's submit lead form. The conversion event is there. It's saying inactive. Now, it can sometimes take a little bit of time for the data to start coming through. And now we're going to go back to the Google Tag Manager. If you haven't got this set up already, make sure that you have the Google Conversion Linker installed. Under tag configuration, type in Google Conversion Linker, then you're going to press into the section here, and then you press Google Ads. And here, you're going to press Conversion Linker. You need to make sure that if you have a Google Tag Manager account, that you have this installed as a tag as well. You don't have to press any of these checkboxes here, but under triggering, you want to press trigger, and then you press all pages. Press save up here. We already have the conversion link already saved. Now, after you've submitted those, you're going to press here at the top, submit. This is going to activate the changes in your Google Tag Manager, meaning that everything that you just inputted is going to be put into the system. Then you're going to go back to the Google Ads Manager. And under the goals setting, we will be able to see the newly created conversion event here under submit lead form. This is the new one. It says inactive at the moment. So what I do is wait a couple of hours and come back. If not, what we're going to do is not test this. So we're going to go back into Google Tag Manager and go through the conversion process to see and make sure that conversion event is firing. So you're going to press preview up here at the top. We're going to preview. We're going to add in our URL and then go through the conversion process on the website. And it will tell you if the conversion events are firing or not. So now the thank you page has been triggered. We're going to go back to Google Tag Manager here at the top where it says tag assistant and connected. Press continue. I'm here. I've actually changed the name of them. So this one here is coming through. through candidate form submission is the one that I called it, and this one's firing. So you can see here tags fired and then list the conversion event that we've just added. If it says tags not fired, then we have to do a debug and see why it's not working. Maybe try the other version where it's hitting the thank you page. We can see here that the thank you page conversion has also hit with both of those installed, if either one are working or the other isn't working. So let me know in the comments down below if it isn't working for you and you want to know exactly how to debug this. It might mean that there is a connection lost somewhere or broken, but hopefully you will see now conversions that you've just set up appearing here in the debug mode. Now, guys, we're going to go into Google Tag Manager. We're going to go to Google Analytics and make sure that the event is also being created in Google Analytics. So we've created it in Google Ads, we've linked it in Google Tag Manager, and now we're going to Google Analytics to also create that conversion event. So what you're going to do is go to Admin, and then you're going to scroll down to Events. They're called goals as well, or conversions. Then we're going to go and create an event. Press create event here. And then you can press create again. And then under convert custom event name, we're going to name the same thing here. So submit lead form. So again, we can track and see exactly what's going on. So under event name, we're going to press equals, and you're going to type in page underscore view. And then you can press here under add condition. This is where we're going to tell Google Analytics where specifically this is going to fire. So here under the parameter, you're going to press page location, scroll all the way down to the bottom, about halfway down where it says page location, and then where it says equals, press the value of the thank you page again. So we're going to grab the thank you page URL, type in the value of the thank you page here, and then press create. Done. Now, we're not quite finished. To find the events in the first place, you need to go to admin and then go to events, and all of the events that you've got are all listed here. So if there is something super important to your business, so leads form submit is number one priority. You want to mark all of your conversions as super important to your business as key events. This tells Google Analytics this is really important to you and is going to prioritize optimizing for around those conversion events over everything else. If it doesn't appear straight away, don't worry, it will appear. Just wait 24 hours and the conversion event will be listed right here. So hopefully that was useful to you guys. But that's it for today, Ad Gang. Hopefully that was useful. Hopefully that gives you some understanding as to how to set conversion tracking up on Google Ads, to feeding it into Google Tag Manager, and implementing conversions on Google Analytics to ensure that your Google Ads are working the best, getting the best out of your ads, and getting the best for your business. So guys, if you're doing it a different way, I'd love to hear about it. If you've got any questions at all into how I've gone through the setup today, let me know. Hit my comment down below. I'm your boy Jerry the Ad Wizard, and we're here many times a week. If you want to follow me, at Jerry Griffiths on LinkedIn, at Jerry Ad Wizard on Instagram, and at Jared Relux everywhere else. If you have a calendar booking tool for your business and you want to book consultations and you want to know how to get the best practice on setting that up in Google Ads and Google Tag Manager, click this video over here. Thank you so much, guys, for being here. Thank you for all the support. I'm your boy Jerry the Ad Wizard, and wherever you are in the world, I bid you peace and love. A wonderful rest of your day. And as always, I'll catch you in the next one.